We want to solve the system of linear equations by graphing. To solve a system of equations, we want to determine the values of x and y that satisfy both of the equations. To do this graphically, we'll sketch both lines on the same coordinate plane, and then based upon the graph, we can determine the solution. When we graph two lines on the same coordinate plane, there are three possible outcomes. If the two lines intersect in one point, as we see here, that means there's one solution, and the solution would be the coordinates of the point of intersection. This type of system is classified as being consistent, and the equations are independent. If we graph the two lines and there are no points of intersection, then the system has no solutions because the lines have no points in common. This system is classified as inconsistent, but the equations are still independent because we do have different lines. And the last outcome is if the two lines are on top of one another or they coincide, and because they have an infinite number of points in common, the system has an infinite number of solutions. In this case, we classify the system as consistent because there are solutions, but because the equations are the same, the equations are dependent. So going back to our example, looking at our two linear equations, we can graph these by any method. Notice the first equation is in standard form, and the second equation is in slope-intercept form. Remember, slope-intercept form is the form y equals mx plus b, where b is the y-intercept and m is the slope of the line. Looking back at number one, we could very easily solve this equation for y, so both equations would be in slope-intercept form. Let's go ahead and do that. If we have 2x plus y equals 4, we can subtract 2x on both sides. This would give us y equals negative 2x plus 4. Notice the slope of both lines is negative 2, but the y-intercepts are different. The first line has a y-intercept of positive 4, the second line has a y-intercept of negative 5. If we want to graph the blue line, we'll first plot the y-intercept of positive 4. Now to make use of the slope, we want it to be a fraction, so we'll put negative 2 over 1. So the negative 2 tells us to go down 1 unit, and the positive 1 tells us to go right 1 unit. So we'll go down 2, right 1. Let's do that again, down 2, right 1. And now we'll sketch the first line. And now we'll graph the second line of the red line where we have a y-intercept of negative 5. And the slope is negative 2 or negative 2 over 1. So we'll go down 2 units and right 1 unit. Down 2, right 1. And now we'll sketch this line. Now you may have already recognized this, but these two lines are parallel. And we should have recognized that because they do have the same slope but different y-intercepts. And since these two lines never intersect, that tells us that there's no solution to this system of equations, which means we can classify this system of equations as inconsistent, and then because the linear equations are different, the equations are independent.